there's some people who believe that the world will be safer if cars drive and the people don't. Because the cars don't get upset, they don't get in a hurry, they don't have vindictive reactions to anything, they just drive. And moreover, the car has to be talking to each other about what they're planning to do so that they can coordinate actions and make it safer for all of us. So the world would be safer if we stopped driving cars and let the cars do that on their own. So those are the kinds of things that are going to be emerging out of the internet environment, and I haven't even touched on the plans for the interstellar expansion of the internet. We've already got an interplanetary internet underway. Now there's a project going on to go to the nearest star and bring communications there.
Thanks, Ben. Do we have any other questions from the audience? Sorry,
I'm here. Hi, Ben. What advice?
Hi there.
What advice would you give to a school as such, an education establishment that's looking to upgrade their information technology, as bring it forward to the relevant?
Yes, good question. And in fact, that question has been asked of me by a school here in Northern Virginia called the Thomas Jefferson High School for Science and Technology. They're just in the middle of a major upgrade, a $200 million upgrade of the school campus. And the question was, what kind of information technology investment should they make? And the answer turned out to be, don't buy a whole lot of computing equipment and invest in that and put it in the school. Instead, invest in high-speed access to the internet, 100 megabit access if possible, or gigabit access even better, and make use of cloud computing as the primary engine for doing computing, for letting kids try out new software, experiment, and so on. The reason that that turns out to be important is that instead of investing in a piece of hardware which will simply get stale at a fairly rapid pace, instead you invest in the infrastructure that gives you access to computers that are going to be upgraded in the normal course of events. So this is not just getting to the Google Cloud, but getting to the Amazon Cloud, and getting to the Microsoft Cloud, and getting to the IBM Clouds, and so on. So that was our advice. Clearly you need end devices, you need terminals and things like that, and maybe some computing resources for doing experimental work, for example, network security. But for the most part, the serious computation for dealing with large-scale databases, for allowing for collaboration, access to a cloud-based resource is by far the best strategy for the rest of this decade.
Great. Thank you very much, Ben. I'm going to close now because I think we've taken up a huge chunk of your time and everyone here. But thank you for your time. And hello.
Okay. My pleasure. All right. Take care, everybody. Good luck.
Thank you.
Bye for now.